Deep in the Ozark National Forest lies a journey that beckons to those who seek adventure and connection. Today, we've teamed up with our friend and fellow explorer, Michael, from Arkansas Off-Road Adventures, to tackle the legendary Ozark Overland Adventure Trail. The Ozark Overland Adventure Trail stretches 293 miles through the Ozark National Forest, divided into five distinct routes, one for each day of the journey. The section we're exploring today covers approximately 30 miles and is known as Day 2, promising a day full of adventure and breathtaking views. So fasten your seatbelts and get buckled in, because we're in for a wild one. Our adventure begins on a rain-soaked morning in Sand Gap, Arkansas. As we gather with Michael and his group, the rain pours down, adding an extra layer of excitement to our day. We've been eager to tackle the Ozark Overland Adventure Trail from start to finish, but when Michael invited us to join him for today's segment, we couldn't pass up the chance to explore together. Michael's always been great company, sharing our passion for inspiring others to connect with nature through overlanding, camping, and trail riding. So with the rain pouring down and spirits high, we're ready to hit the trail and embrace whatever the day brings.
Oh, people are coming in. Look at that.
Hey, it's raining.
You don't say.
No, it's pouring. It ain't raining. It's pouring now.
We'll hang out in the back.
As we roll out with Michael and the crew, the rain keeps coming down, but that's just part of the adventure. After a quick pit stop at a roadside rest area, we hit the trailhead just south of Sand Gap, Arkansas. The drive to the trailhead is a time to connect, to share stories and laughs as we prepare for the day ahead.
Didn't take this ditch long to put some water in it.
The rain adds a sense of mystery, but we're ready to embrace whatever comes our way.
We've been running into a lot of wild hogs out here too, big groups of them.
Yeah, Chris, for those that don't know,
quick, Chris, turn your headlights off.
It's the perfect reminder that it isn't just about the destination, it's about the journey, the moments in between, and the people that you share it with.
Yeah, we've been fortunate. It started dry, but then it turned around pretty good. And every day that it's nice and cool in the summer, that's one day you don't have to burn up. Ain't that scary?
This section of the trail is just the beginning, a warm-up for what's to come.
Yeah,
look how up that trail is. It's like straight up and down. You still can't see it in the camera though. It does not look very dramatic in the camera.
That's wicked because it looks like it's literally straight up. It's like a cliff. Like I wouldn't want to walk up it. What
like,
the heck?
Who is crawling their vehicles up that thing, you know?
Like a side-by-side trail.
Right here.
Out by where we live, we have a lot of pine, and all the pine needles are just, I mean, by the boatloads are just falling out of the trees.
Yeah, it's that way at our house. We're privileged to have raining all over our jeeps.
That would drive me crazy because I hate it. They get stuck inside your windshield wiper blades and stuff.
Ugh. Yeah, they do that too. A cool little cabin right here on the left hand side of this map. See the top wall? Yeah, I've seen that. I could definitely come down in here and stay.
As we approach the more technical sections, we take a moment to air down and get our convoy in line. There's something special about these moments in our trips. Everyone's focused, the vehicles are prepared, and the excitement is palpable. The trail intensifies as we move deeper into the forest. The rain hasn't let up yet, and the mud is thick and unforgiving. One by one, the vehicles in our convoy tackle the trail, the sound of engines roaring and the tires gripping through the mud. This is where we test ourselves, our vehicles, and our teamwork.
Taking our time, we're good. And a little bit longer than the rest of us, so, you know, we're doing okay. That last little rock there was probably the hardest bit so far.
Yeah, I bet.
When we came across a fallen tree blocking our path, it's time to pull out the chainsaw and winch, working together to clear the way.
That's a sticker bus too, because I grabbed it when I slipped.
It's trips like these you'll never forget, facing obstacles head on with a team that's got your back.
All you boys can probably just push it, huh? Get wet and muddy?
What?
Oh, look, or one guy can do it. He's heavy.
And then the mud hole, a test of will and skill. While most of us took the bypass, a couple of brave souls went right through the thick of it, showing just how capable these machines and their drivers really are.
Just nice, because we used to have to get on it unbolted every single time.
Yeah,
once you hit like 16, 17, 18, it'll just auto reconnect. We're used to going like 20, 30, you know, almost around there without the sway bars on, and it's just smooth. Oh my gosh, it's smooth. But I don't like that, I guess.
No. So, we wished for rain.
We got it.
We got rain. We're soaked.
It is weirdly a cold day in the middle of August for Arkansas. It is 65 degrees right now and raining, and it is cold.
We are all cold. Sitting out there freezing. Yeah, I think everybody's got their heaters on today. I like it though.
Yeah. Okay. And that's the thing, I know I'm complaining, but I would much rather be doing this than sitting at home. Heck yeah.
Yeah. And it's still better than the, like, height of the summer heat.
Yeah, it's better than sweating your butt off. Ooh, yeah. Look at this little hole. Starting to warm up a little bit, at least not much, but a little bit, and the rain is starting to die down, so that's nice. Makes it a little easier getting out, moving around, but man, is it muddy. It is a soupy mess.
After the intense trail riding, we take a well-deserved break at Pilot Knob Mountain. The views are breathtaking, a reminder of why we do this. We love finding places where you can pause, take it all in, and appreciate the beauty of the world around you.
You can really see it on the yellow. Yeah. It is too, it's just falling off.
So. We say goodbye to a few friends, but the journey isn't over yet. The toughest part of the trail is still ahead.
Look at that, that's pretty cute, isn't it? You gonna get back in?
Everything. But no, we love doing this. That way, I like to do it. I like to show people that there's a lot to do, and there's more to sitting at home on a couch.
As we approach the most challenging part of the trail, the memories of our last trip come flooding back. We've been here before, but this time we're ready to conquer it.
Tree's attacking me. We are back for redemption for Major Tom.
Yeah.
That rock ledge, this Jeep's got to prove itself. It's going to belong in the Big Rock family. It's got to do it. We have to do it.
Is that right?
I keep getting attacked by branches. The forest is fighting back.
With Michael leading the way, we push forward. Determined to redeem ourselves and see if our new Gladiator Rubicon can handle what our old Jeep couldn't. It's a true test of our skills and our vehicle's capabilities.
Pretty hard to the right up on that bank and then let it drop back to the left. I got one. I grabbed one of the other walkies.
Well, slide into it right here. Man, I forgot. Now you're gonna slide in. Man, sometimes I wish that he had a video camera in front of there to get some of the faces I make at him when he's doing stuff. That was scary. How'd that feel?
Yeah, I'm shaking. That was super fun, though. I tell you what, though, it felt a lot better than it did last time. I think maybe just because of the amount of speed I kept that time. But maybe just the difference in truck and all that stuff. I don't know. That didn't feel that bad. Man, I mean, it don't matter. That was still terrifying.
With the toughest obstacle behind us, the trail starts to open up, offering a smoother ride and a chance to catch our breath. The rain begins to ease, revealing the stunning landscape of the Ozarks. As we make our way to Haw Creek Falls, we take in the lush surroundings and reflect on the day's adventure. The camaraderie, the challenges, and the incredible scenery make every mile worth it.
Oh my gosh, we're 24 degrees sideways.
This is the essence of overlanding, finding joy in the journey and peace in the wild places we explore. Overlanding is more than just a hobby. It's a way to connect with the world around us, to push our limits, and to find peace in the wild. As we say our goodbyes and make our way home, we're left with memories of another incredible adventure. If you've enjoyed this journey, we'd love your support. Give us a like, a thumbs up, and turn on those bell notifications. We're all explorers at heart, so get out there, connect with nature, and create your own adventures.
Chris went to that and made Ray look horrible. He went over and I was like, there ain't no way.
All right, we're gonna say goodbye. My name's Corey. Kayla's back here running around. That's Michael from Arkansas Off-Road Adventures. Make sure you guys go give him a follow on YouTube, and we'll see you guys in the next one.